members of the garrison staff during last week's commander's call. The Halloween costume contest, judged by garrison commander, Captain America, saw a team from CYSS take home the top prize. Hello and welcome to Meade Week. I'm Brian Spann. Also on this edition, MWR has a new website. Leisure travel is in a new location. November is Military Appreciation Month. All these stories and more. But first, November is also National Disability Employment Awareness Month. It's a day set aside to celebrate the contributions of all of American workers with disabilities. Last week, the Fort Meade Equal Employment Opportunity Office hosted its annual observation with a presentation by retired Army Master Sergeant Cedric King. Master Sergeant King, a double amputee resulting from injuries sustained in Afghanistan, shared a message of turning life's setbacks into positives.
Take whatever happens and be resourceful enough to turn it into something better. That's your challenge in life. You can't stop bad stuff from happening anyway. You couldn't if you wanted to. Take the bad stuff and make it into something good. And every now and again, it won't work like this every time, but every now and again, when you do that, you pull the lotto handle and you hit the jackpot. Get your reps up of getting that door slammed in your face. That's okay. It's okay. Get your reps up. One of those reps is going to be the magical repetition that's going to turn your life from where it is now into something that you never imagined.
Later this week, I'll post Master Sergeant King's entire presentation on the Meade TV YouTube channel. Meanwhile, MWR has a new website. The new web address is meade.armymwr.com. The new site has all the same great information, but with a new look. Once again, MWR has a new website. You'll want to update your bookmarks with the new address, meade.armymwr.com. More news from MWR. Leisure Travel Service is now in a new location. They've moved from Outdoor Rec on Wilson Street to the Arts and Crafts Center in building 6530 on York Avenue. These shots were taken last week during the move. They're open for business today with new hours Monday through Friday, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. In other news, the Garrison's Veterans Day observance is coming up Tuesday, November 10th at 2 p.m. at the Fort Meade Museum. This year's guest speaker is Michael Knapp, the Director for Historical Services for the American Battle Monuments Commission. Once again, the Garrison Veterans Day ceremony is Tuesday, November 10th at 2 o'clock at the Post Museum. In a related story, Army Community Service is hosting a Family Day of Service in celebration of National Family Appreciation Day. It's coming up Tuesday, November 17th from 11 to 2 at the McGill Training Center. The Day of Service features holiday arts and crafts projects that will be donated to some good causes.
In recognition of National Family Appreciation Day, ACS is providing an opportunity for our community members, free of charge, to make arts and craft projects that we'll distribute to the Armed Forces Retirement Home, to our Better Opportunity for Single Soldiers group, and for our families that are geographically separated for the holidays. So it's a wonderful event. We provide all the supplies. And it's in recognition of a family day of service, having our families come out and show their appreciation for the community in celebration of families and volunteerism.
And finally on this edition, another reminder about the upcoming electronic recycling and data destruction event. It's coming up Friday, November 13th from 9:30 to 1 at the commissary parking lot. Securus, an IT recycling and destruction company, will be bringing a truck to haul away your unwanted electronics. So what can you bring?
We say anything with a plug, but we don't accept refrigerators or appliances, stuff like that. Printers, copiers, networking adapters, laptops, computers, games, video games. Those types of items we accept.
There are some specific items you can bring, like alkaline batteries, appliances with Freon, and fire detectors. Additionally, some electronics will be accepted, but there may be a disposal charge. These items include TVs, hard drives, and backup batteries. For a complete list of what's acceptable and not acceptable, or if a disposal charge is involved, go to our Facebook page, and in the pictures section, you'll find the Securus flyer. Once again, the electronics recycling event is coming up November 13th. If you have any questions, contact Fort Meade's Environmental Division at 301-677-9170. That's Meade Week for this week. I'm Brian Spann. For everyone at Meade TV and the Fort Meade Public Affairs Office, have a great Meade Week.